Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Greensburg, Pennsylvania, where tonight the 3-0 Shaler Area Titans come in to play the 1-2 Hemfield Spartans. Hi, everybody. John Irwin alongside Matt Prucker for coverage of tonight's game. And Matt, we've got a pretty good game for ourselves tonight as the Titans face the Spartans, who were last year didn't go in favor of the Titans, but tonight could be a whole new story. Tell me a little bit about what you want to see from the Titans.
So, Titans, you want to come out better than you did last time you played against these guys. They got crushed. It was just not what you want to see. Both sides of the ball completely fell apart. However, the tables have turned, as you would say, as the Titans have gotten better. Starting off the season 3-0, their most recent victory, a 28-14 win over Plum, that they were able to take over that game in the second half and really keep going. Keegan Smetanka, as usual, fantastic on the day, with one passing touchdown to Kay Norga, who got his first touchdown of the season and made two unbelievable highlight grabs that we were just completely shocked.
Absolutely.
Absolutely insane catches. And then Joey Rispoli forcing a fumble, being a menace, scored a touchdown as a running back. And now they to close it out and make that game 28-14 at the final. But now they're going against Hemfield, a game that they want revenge for sure after that last time. And speaking of Hemfield, John, what do you got on them?
Yeah, Hemfield right now trying to claw their way back into the win column for sure. Started out the season, big win, 45-8 against Greensburg, but now two back-to-back losses against Connellsville and Latrobe, most recently 27-7 against Latrobe. For them, it's just been getting the offense started. Right now, a lot of quarterback issues, starting out with Kieran Littman. Not bad in yardage, 350 on the year, but two touchdowns, three interceptions, 59 completion percentage. They're running now two other quarterbacks, that being Dominic DeTruth and Kieran Littman's younger brother, Camden. So for them, might need to see a little bit more running from Lucas Moore and Rogan Catcher tonight. But for the Titans, what do they need to do to pull another big win and put themselves in the history books?
I think they just can't get caught up in a moment. We mentioned we made a big deal last week that if they won, they would go 3-0 for the first time since 2009. You said before we went on the air, they have to act like they've been here before, and I think they've got that. They've got a great senior leadership, and what they need to do is just act like they've been there before, and then limit mistakes and turnovers. Made a couple of turnovers last week, which didn't help their cause, and had some struggles in the red zone. So if they can keep their calm, and I would really like to see Brandon London to get going. He's such a big part of their offense, and especially going into conference play here in a couple of weeks. If they can get him going, he'll be a great complement to DiSabato and Orga in the passing game.
Absolutely. I agree with you. I think Brandon London can be a big part of tonight's game. I think more confident reps is what we might want to see. You know, a couple of incompletions last time. We know he had a problem with his hand. But if you're going to go against Franklin Regional, who right now sits at 3-0 as well, playing Gateway tonight, he's going to need to be a bigger part of this offense. Now, for Hemfield, they need to switch things up. They need to bring back the Hemfield of last year that came into the Titans' house and blew the brakes off of them. Now, how does that happen? I think just confidence. I think you really need to gain your confidence back. You really need to win your fans back. I think you need to say to yourselves, hey, we've had two rough games in a row, but that doesn't mean we need to have the season be a loss. Doesn't need to be a lost season. The Titans, they can pull off one of the upsets, the Spartans can pull off one of the upsets of the season, in my opinion. If you knock off the Titans right now, you get yourselves back on track, and it puts the Titans in a tough position going into Franklin. I think just play your game. Don't play safe, but play your game like you're used to it, and good things can happen. Who are your key players for tonight?
So I already talked about London for Shaler, and I think Rispoli is going to be a big piece of that too. Also Sammy Tapp, who's going to get the start for Carson Pierce, who is going to be out likely until North Hills, possibly come back from Woody High, but everything's got to go right. But I think the defense, if they can hold things out, it's not just one player obviously on defense, but if they can limit their rushing attack, that's going to be the key for the Titans offense and the Titans defense.
Absolutely. I agree with you there. I think Rispoli can have another big game tonight. I think he can show some leadership to Tapu, like you just said. Really guide the defense. I think they have to play lights out, obviously, again. That defense has been one of the best in the Whipple, only allowing 14 points, or I think it's 10 points a game.
Yeah, they've been averaging 10 points a game.
10 points a game. I mean, absolutely lights out, on the offense. I'd like to see a little bit more from Joey DiSabato. I think just last game had a little quieter game, so unfortunately for him, just really didn't get what he wanted. But I think tonight he can have a really good game, get himself back up. Again, second in reception so far in the entire Whipple, so we should see some more from him. But other than that, if you want to see what does happen tonight, catch us up in the booth for coverage of tonight's game.
Go Titans!
Woo! And welcome back up into the booth for coverage of tonight's game. John Irwine and Matt Pruckert up here in the booth at the Cavs take the field. Matt, we talked about it earlier in the pregame. This could be a game of two different sides right now. As much as we want to say this could be a close one, the Titans are on a roll right now, and Hempfield's struggling to get back into it.
Yeah, exactly. When you go with the Spartans, you're 2 for your last 8 games. So they're really hoping to get a win here. And for both of these teams, the schedule doesn't really get much easier than this. They're coming into the difficult, going into conference play, always when the games step up, because you're getting rivalry games, and the teams are just simply better conference generally than out of conference. So Titans hoping to get some revenge once again and really make a statement with this game tonight, going up against a team that on paper you should beat, but there's a reason why games are played on the field and not on paper, John.
Absolutely. I love that quote. And as the Cavs take the field, that's a great point, because season doesn't get any easier for both of these teams. You could say the Titans possibly have the hardest in-section play. You know, it's up there in 5A. I mean, you have Pine Richland, Penn Hills on a roll, obviously. Penn Hills, the number one rated team in 5A. Pine, I think, sits at 2. The Titans now sit in the top 5 of 5A after beating Plum. Plum dropped out. The Titans moved up both in the Gazette and in the Trib, and obviously getting a lot of attention outside from Whipple Insider and other insider sources in the Whipple. The Titans, they're starting to stop being an underdog and starting to really be what they wanted to be, more of a, I wouldn't say a powerhouse just yet, but I'm saying they're a team that other teams want to beat.
Yeah, definitely a team that makes some noise. You're not going to walk into Titan Stadium and expect to come away with a blowout victory like maybe, 5 years ago?
Yeah.
So this is a team with a new identity. Coach Ryan has done a great job of that, changing identity. Really, ever since day one, those results you've really starting to see in these past 2 years.
Yeah, absolutely. And as the Titans take the field, they're going to receive the kick, and that's going to be could be a good start for the Titans, taking the field early here. Again, they struggled last week against Plum, really putting it on into the end zone against the Mustangs, and they had about 2 scoring drives, both in the red zone, 1 inside the 10 that did not end up in points for the Titans. Now tonight, can they make a difference and really start hot in this first quarter?
It's definitely going to be the key, and that's exactly what you want to do. It's definitely something that Coach Ryan said, hey, we got to make sure we do a better job of this, and most of the time these Titans respond.
Yeah, absolutely, and I this is a very well-organized and coordinated group. But Hempfield, same thing. Can they bounce back? And Josh Riley right now will start things off here on a Friday night in Hempfield area. Good boot, back. Caden Orga's going to return the kick from the 15, guts left. Finds a gap, but it's going to get stopped anyways at the 25-yard line. The Titans are going to take the field. Now, Matt, what do the Titans got to do to get really started hot here in this first possession?
Well, they come down, at the very least, get a couple of first downs and establish their tempo for the game. And they've usually started hot. They have scored multiple times on their opening drives here in the season. And now they've got to start and set this tempo. This is how this game's going to be. Set the pace. And we're going to see what they do right here, starting with Keegan Spatanka.
Absolutely. And how do they line up is the question. They go to a 2-man set. And the shotgun, Spatanka. Moves a man in motion. It'll be Di Sabato. They give it up to Razo up the gut. He'll gain 3. Now they'll give him 2. And Razo again. In my opinion, one of the workhorses on that backside of the offense. Again, not many touchdowns in his name, not a whole lot of praise for him in the articles, but again, the yards that he can get per game is so monumental. 6 yards per carry, I mean, that's huge for the Titans. And they give it back to him again, up the middle, and an open field now with the 50. Gets dragged past the 50. And Nate Razo, an instant impact for the Titans. Razo, once again, the
ball carrier. That's something they're going to want to stay dedicated to. Get this run game going. Take some pressure off Spatanka's shoulders. And even though they had a 2-yard gain the first time, didn't phase and went right back to it with a huge gain there and a Titan first down.
Yeah, the Titans taking no time to get set. They hand the ball off to the right. Razo pushes the man down, but he'll lose a yard. And that's an interesting start for the Titans. Just straight run to start the game. And it's probably just to put Hempfield a little bit on their toes.
Yep, stay committed to the run. That was a good play there by Brennan Knight. He's their star player on Hempfield's defense. You're going to see him in the backfield a lot. He's one of the 3 returning seniors from last year.
Now Spatanka rolls left. Gets good blocks. Open field in front. Has his man. It'll be a first down, I believe. No, they're going to mark him a yard short. It was a Caden Orga.
and Caden Orga last week, and your and I opinion, player of the game against Plum.
Yeah, absolutely. Two absolutely insane catches that really helped the Titans gain some momentum and put Plum away.
Got his first touchdown last week. Definitely took a lot of pressure off his shoulders. Schmitenka under center, hands it to Razo, and he'll get the first, and we'll move the chains. So a hot start for the Titans inside of a minute and a half here. And now how does Hemfield respond here?
Razo, the ball carrier.
Well, a couple of big chunk plays.
Stopped by 55.
An 11-yard gain there on the last play. 2 yards here to pick up the first down. And they've got to make sure they contain Razo and maybe force Schmitenka to try to beat him, although it's been the opposite case for a lot of games this season.
They move plans in motion, give it up to Razo. And he'll get 4 on the carry. So a good start from Razo. I mean, I know I was saying he was, you know, underrated and not really talked about in the articles. And, you know, he's a workhorse. And, man, he's proving it right now on this first drive.
Yeah, they like going to him right now to start. And so far it's been paying off. He's had some nice carries.
Same formation. Schmitenka rolls. Has a man deep. Decent battle with separation. And it goes to London instead for a Shaler touchdown. What a wacky throw to Brandon London, but a touchdown nonetheless for the Shaler Titans inside of two and a half minutes here.
We talked about what can the Titans do to get Brandon London going. Throw the ball deep. Both DiSabato and London burning their respective defenders. And that was pretty funny. He comes in right behind and said, I'll take that. Thank you very much. And
yeah,
that's
London,
6 points.
London beat his man right into DiSabato's route, who also beat his man. And London gets the touchdown.
Like in a retro bowl when you have two receivers going to the same spot.
So now Douglas can put another one on the board. Up. Oh, he hit the post. So Douglas misses his first PAT on the night. So the score will stay 6-0 in favor of the Titans. So a little lucky break there for the Hempfield Spartans if they go down and score. But again, that's if they go down and score against the Titans defense that some have said have been one of the best in the Whipple.
Yeah, and those uprights are still shaking. He absolutely smoked that into the right upright.
He has a laser on that foot. And now the question is, with Douglas, how is this kickoff going to be? You know, are you a little bit nervous of, hey, now I got to actually focus on this kick now, put this thing in a good place so they don't get a good return?
I think mainly he's just going to boot it out of frustration. He's going to put a lot of power into this one, send it into the end zone.
You just got to be careful here. As much as the scoring has shown for the Hempfield Spartans, they still can put points on the board. Catcher back deep to receive. Waiting for the boot from Douglas. And Douglas gets a good squib into it, and catcher's going to take it from the goal line. He has a gap up the middle, cuts right. And just short before the 30, not a bad take at all from the goal line from catcher.
He did a good job there taking the space he was given. Some good blocking up front allowed him to not really meet any defenders until he got past the 20-yard line.
Yep, Alex Weber on the tackle there from the Titans, stopping catcher from getting any more yards there. So now the Spartans looking to respond here with 9:37 remaining in the first. And this is going to be an interesting start for them as Kieran Lippman takes the field. He's had some problems recently. Will he step up tonight and make an impact? Moves his men in motion. Catcher. He's going to give it to him on the left side. DiSabato closes the gap, and he'll get a gain of 4. And what we saw last week from the Titans was that against that Plum run game, they started to pull their safeties up and move them back into the middle and say, hey, if you're going to run it, we're going to be ready for it, and we'll allow you to throw it, but we're not worried about it. Will they do the same here is the question.
Well, going up against a similar quarterback, he threw 3 picks the last game. Titans an opportunistic.
And a fumble under the legs of Lippman. He has to fall in at the 20. And it's going to be a flag, I believe, for a late hit.
Flag on the play.
I don't know about that one, John. The defender tried to let up there, and he.
I know play is dead once you fall on it, but that's a pretty harsh first flag to throw.
Yeah, so going back to the point I made, that Titans were an opportunistic defense, and they're going to look to continue forcing turnovers, and they're going to hope to take advantage of whatever Hempfield brings.
And it is going to be a penalty against the Titans. So an unfortunate turn of events. It was Connor Lunnan on there trying to get to the ball. Just slid into Lippman. So what would have been a loss of 12 brings the ball back up.
Personal foul against the Titans.
So a weird turn of events here on this first drive for the Spartans. So Lippman now. Shaler shows blitz. And now two penalties in a row for the Titans. Now this Titans defense that we said needed to play lights out. Two unfortunate and unnecessary mistakes in a row. I mean, Hemphill has only had one play.
You just got to settle things down if you're the Titans right now. Nothing to get too excited about, but at the same time, discipline's going to be important, especially in this game here. You already have the lead.
So now a third and two, or three, excuse me. Lippman gives the ball. It'll be a loss of one.
Rispoli right on cue. Yep.
Rispoli read it and stopped catcher, and it'll be a fourth down. So the Titans get away with that there. And you just got to wonder if those that penalty doesn't happen against Lund and then another offsides there from the Titans. This could have been way worse of a punt for the Spartans.
Yeah, they're going to get an extra 15 yards out of this, so good for the field position game.
Now Josh Riley, the kicker, gets a high boot to it. Very good. Orga's going to let it bounce out of bounds just around the 34, and that's where they'll mark it. So the Titans get the ball back with 8:04 remaining in the first. And if you're the Titans, you're going to do the same thing. Oh, I'm not saying, you know, run the ball over and over again, but play like how you just played last drive. You've got nothing to change yet.
Yeah, check and check. Score on your opening drive, stop them from scoring. Can't ask much more than that,
John. Absolutely, and again, that's what the Titans need to do. They needed to step up that first quarter and that first half intensity, which I thought they lost a little bit from last game.
And perhaps a couple of red zone turnovers hurt them there for sure.
Now Shmatenka in the shotgun. Two receivers set out wide. It'll be a design roll to the left. Has to scramble. And he'll get dragged down, a sack in the backfield for the Spartans. What a play, Brock Heisler on the sack. And Shmatenka, a man who does not go down often, takes a sack on the first play of the possession.
Hemphill did a great job of getting outside of Shaler's tackles and containing Shmatenka inside. Usually he's able to roll out to the outside. Wasn't the case here.
So it'll be a second and 27 now for the Titans. So they'll start to pinch everybody back inside, get some more protection. And that'll be another flag on the Titans. Three penalties in 2 minutes for the Titans.
It'll be a false start in the left tackle.
And Jim Ryan's team, which we talked about, which is so disciplined, so penalty, you know, no penalties, no mistakes, have backed themselves up right now onto a second and 32 inside their own 15 yards.
At the very least, you don't want to compound mistakes here by trying to force something and turning it over.
It's still only second down for the Titans. They show blitz. Shmatenka with time has to launch it deep for Orga. Looking for a flag, doesn't get it. It'll be an incomplete pass. So a shaky start on this possession for the Titans.
Yeah, Orga was turning around trying to find the ball. He couldn't, and when he finally did, the defender was in the way.
And right now, the Spartans are getting through this Titan O-line that has held so strong for Keegan Shmatenka. Brennan Knight was in on that one, trying to chase down Shmatenka. He had to get it off. They move plans in motion, give it to Razo, but he'll be stopped short. Ball popped out. But they'll say it's a fourth down. He was down. Spartans, for what I would say, an impressive stop there on their defensive side of things.
And it all started from the big sack on first down. Once you get that far behind the chains, it's really hard to try to get a first down afterwards.
And now Douglas will boot it away to catcher. It's a good boot to the 50. No fair catch. Squeaks left. He'll gain a couple of yards before a bunch of Titans push him down at the 45.
It was a good catch by Douglas. That was a high snap. He was able to grab it and get it off. And good for the Spartans, who will start their next drive in Shaler territory.
And for the Titans, you just have to say, you can't be too leisurely right now. You've already put points on the board, but you can't say, all right, you know, now we're coast, you know, we're cruising right now. You're not really out of it yet. You're only up a touchdown.
Yeah, in football, game can change on any play. So got to make sure you keep your discipline here. Limit your mistakes. A couple of penalties start things off. But now you just got to keep playing the game you've been playing all year long.
Yep. Now Littman, they're going to move into a wildcat formation. DeTruth now, the second QB on the roster, will look left, pump, looking for something, gets sacked by Battaglia in the backfield.
Yeah, Raza read that play perfectly. You saw he was trying to go for the screen pass to the left, but as soon as that was gone, second receiver was covered, and then he just had to get out of there and take a sack.
And the Titans put that one away quick. Don't allow a trick play to happen to themselves. And they're going to keep DeTruth out there with Littman.
Yeah, they've been using a little bit of using three quarterbacks. This is their sophomore. This is the guy that they like for the future. Interesting to see how this works out.
And a five-man set. Shaler shows blitz. DeTruth looking deep, looking for Littman. And it's incomplete. Caden Orga and Razo on the coverage.
Yeah, Orga nearly had that as an interception. Good job by the receiver just to get his hands in the way at the very least and make an incomplete pass.
And it's good on Orga and Razo to not have to go for the interception right away. You'll see a lot of guys really see that floating ball and they'll put their hands up and go for the interception. And like we saw last week with Orga, a receiver sees that. He's going to rip that ball right out of your hands.
This will be a nice stop for the Titans if they can get off the field now on third down.
Same formation, five-man, third and 12 for the Spartans. DeTruth getting pressure, has to roll, spins around, evades a man, and incomplete pass. What a breakup there. Tortorella in on that breakup.
And you can see the Titans were able to just get enough pressure. Andrew Bentz, wide receiver, was open in the middle of the field, but he wasn't able to see him because he was too many Titan defenders were in the way.
Good evasiveness from DeTruth, especially on his first drive of the game, but wasn't able to make anything happen on the good coverage by Tortorella. And now Josh Riley again had a good first punt earlier. Can he put it in a good place for his defense to hold the Titans? It'll be a low one. And it'll just squibble to the right and bounce out around the 25-yard line.
Not exactly how you dropped that punt there. Didn't even get inside the 20. And from that range, that's got to be slightly disappointing.
First year punting, I believe, for Josh Riley, kicker of last year and this year, the senior. Has a season-high 44-yard field goal so far this season. Impressive, obviously. Riley Douglas did hit a 45-yarder this season, so pretty long distances so far for kickers so far in the Whipple.
I think that's what you see as the games evolve. You've seen players come from soccer backgrounds. Even though Douglas didn't, this guy's a soccer player, their kicker.
Yeah, and Josh Riley's a volleyball player, actually,
so
for the
too.
Spartans.
So, yeah. He plays both, multi-sport athletes.
You've got a lot of dual athletes now playing football.
See, a lot of athleticism. A lot of these Titan players also play basketball, so...
I believe you said the starting five for the Titans basketball team, four of them play football. And Shpatenka looking right. It'll be a quick screen to Bellis. And he'll get stopped at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a half a yard.
Yeah, it's nice to hear his name called. He's been underutilized a little bit. When you have two great receivers like Orga and DiSabato, it's kind of hard for other touches to go around.
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, again, those are the guys getting the reps. Again, last year, London, Orga, and DiSabato, all 30 receptions plus the whole season. It's hard to not give them the ball. And he'll stay on the field, though, TJ Bellis. They're going to keep the three-man, Orga up high.
Defense has done a solid job.
They give it to DiSabato on the sweep. Doesn't get the block he needed, and he's going to lose yards. Goodness me, what a play from Kieran Littman. So switched out from quarterback into wide receiver and now gets a tackle for loss against the Titans.
Yeah, the Spartans defense has done a good job of creating pressure. And you have to wonder if that's going to lead to a turnover, but they've done a good job of just limiting the Titans, forcing them to go backwards, and now third down and long. Littman, versatile player, quarterback, defensive back. He's been doing it all so far for the Spartans.
So now they're going to switch Bellis up top. Third and 12 for the Titans. Under five remaining in the first. Now they rotate DiSabato. Looking for Orga, middle of the field. Shmatenka gives it to him, just out of his hands. Was in stride at the 50. Shmatenka had to make a 1 foot throw, feeling the pressure behind him and just out of reach for Orga. Would have been a first down, possibly more.
And you see the maturity. Even though he made an incompletion on that play, he sensed the pressure, stayed calm, stepped up in the pocket, and nearly delivered a perfect strike to Orga, who might have been gone for six.
And now the boot from Douglas will go to catcher. He's going to have a good return here. Cuts right at the 40, cuts back inside at the 30, and a great return from catcher. Sets up the Spartans beautifully, and these Spartans are on fire right now.
Come out and done exactly what they wanted to do, except for the first touchdown. Special teams, they've done great. Nice return there, a couple of great returns already, and now they're deep in Titan territory to start their next drive.
And for the Titans, we said it. You can't have the same repeat thing against Plum where you keep getting all these possessions and you keep getting great opportunities to go down the field and score. But this is now turned into, you can't even really get out of your own half right now.
I figure out, that starts from first down. Last couple drives, first down plays have gone backwards.
So now Littman back at quarterback. Catcher behind him. They're going to move catcher in motion. Littman looking right, looking for a scramble left. Has his man across the middle. That's catcher, and he gets inside the 10. That's Ronald catcher on the catch and take.
Littman's pass.
And Littman, good strength there to evade the pressure and find his man, Ronald catcher.
Yeah, there are three catchers on their team, all of them big contributors. And right now they've got him in a great spot here to tie the game.
Yeah, Rogan catcher is the running back right now behind Littman. Ronald is the inside receiver at the bottom of the field. And how do the Titans respond? A first and 9 here inside of the red zone for the Spartans. They move Rogan catcher in motion. Littman looking across the field, just overthrown. The Spartans want a flag. They're going to say it was uncatchable. But close, very close.
Yeah, you could tell just by his release, he didn't quite get enough zip on that throw, and when that happens, it just sails over top. And you're right, if that was closer, it might have been called for PI.
So now they go three-man set, bottom of the field. Titans show blitz, and they jump. Titans, fourth penalty on the night against them. And what is happening with the Titans on discipline sides?
Dead ball. You have to wonder if something came up in the scouting about the snap count, but regardless, they're jumping the snap count, whatever they're doing.
And I believe it was JoJo Raspoli on that jump. One of the leaders on this defense right now, especially from last game with the things he did against Plum, you wouldn't expect him to have a mistake like that.
Well, now you can't focus, dwell on that too much because now you got to try to prevent a score.
Yeah, it'll be a second and 4. Three-man set. Move a man in motion. Littman low snap. They hand it to him on the sweep, but he's going to lose a lot of yards and a big hit there for the Titans.
Bends the ball carrier.
They got to him quick.
Stop by Sammy.
It was Sammy Tapu in on the tackle. The guy that we said was filling in for Carson Pierce comes up with a big stop to make it 3rd and 6.
Could possibly be 4 down territory depending on what happens on this next play.
It'll be a 3-man set to the top. Rogan catcher to the left of Littman. Littman looking left, feels the pressure, has a man, and it'll be incomplete. Looking for Owen Buchholz, wasn't able to find him.
Littman's pass instead of number 9.
So now it is a 4th and 6. And you got to go for it here if you're the Spartans.
Yeah, a couple times here, throws have been errant. And when you're in the red zone like this, you've got to make sure you capitalize. And right now, they haven't been able to do that. Big 4th down here coming up.
Huge 4th down. Titans stop here. You're just not out of the woods yet. You're still pinned inside your 10. Now Littman. Will he take it with his legs, maybe? And the Titans, they think that the Spartans jumped. We'll see what happens with the penalties against the Titans. And they're going to go against the Spartans.
Dead ball.
It'll be a false start. So the Titans catch a break there, and they will go field goal. So that's huge for the Titans. Got away with a play there. A little sigh of relief.
Always better when it ends up being 3 points instead of six.
And again, Riley does still have to put this one through. Got a good boot again. Season high of 44 so far this season. And if you're the Titans, no need to get in there and really try and block this thing. If they make it, they make it. We're going to have a timeout called. Shaler's going to take their first here with 2:45 remaining in the first quarter. And what a weird first quarter we've had.
Yeah, Titans not quite playing what we've seen here first few games of the season. Interesting timeout call here on the field goal.
It's definitely up there. I mean, I said last game, you know, timeouts, obviously Jim Ryan is one of the better coaches, I believe, that holds his timeouts, knows when to take them at the right time, and obviously the Titans are going to trust in this decision on this timeout. I think he's saying, hey, they've already shown us a trick play this one time, right? They're going to have a QB possibly or someone that can throw that's going to be holding this snap. Be ready. Don't fall asleep back there.
Yeah, that's a good point. Just checking your bases. All right, this is what we're going to do.
Yep.
Probably not going to rush it. There is a fake. Got to make sure we stay calm here. Only 12 yards to the end zone.
Again, the Titans are up six. Could have had an extra point, but missed by Riley Douglas. So still in the lead, but only by six. And now with the timeout taken, we do have DiSabato and Orga in the back right around the end zone, just in case the Spartans try something tricky, but it looks like Riley's just going to put this one through. Snap's good, holds good, kick up, and is good from Josh Riley. So Josh Riley puts the Spartans on the board after a huge, what I believe, an impressive couple of possessions from them, especially after that first one from the Titans. And the score now, Matt, didn't mean to interrupt you. Six in favor of the Titans over the Spartans, who have three with 2:40 remaining in the first.
Yeah, smart call there just to take your points. You know, you always want to get the capitalize, get the touchdown, but if you don't get it, then it feels like a big letdown. And now, still a one-score game.
And if you're the Titans, you got to say, all right, the first drive, what we thought was immaculate and was, you know, could have been smooth sailing from there. It's been a bumpy ride after that. We got to ease back into it. Play our game. Like you said, act like you've been here before.
Couple of drives here. Might need to change some things up. These last two drives have not gone well for them.
So now Orga will take it inside his own 15, looking left with speed. Gets all the way to the 35. So good take from Kane Orga. A little bit of pressure now off of this Titan offense to not be pinned inside their own 20.
Yeah, that was a great return. DiSabato had a great return touchdown against Hampton. Orga's good for his showing as well. Nice return, sets him up to 35. And that's been close to the first they've been since that opening drive touchdown.
And now how the Titans line up. They go two-man set receiving core. London on the right. Schmitank in the shotgun. Spartans show blitz. They do. Looking for DiSabato on the comeback route. Had him. And with forward progress, we'll get a gain of seven. And that's the bread and butter, I think, for Joe DiSabato and Keegan Schmitanka, right? That's the go my 7 yards, 8 yards, whatever it might be on the play, come back, catch. We're going to move him a little bit.
Titan staple for sure.
They give it to Razo up the left, looking for a hole, bounces, and he'll lose, I believe, a yard. Nope, they're going to give him the line of scrimmage. But again, this Spartan defense is holding strong right now.
Yeah, Razo was looking for his blocks to set up, but they didn't. And then he tried to bounce it off outside, but didn't quite get there. They're going to move. Looks like they're going to move him up. We're going to give him one. So it'll be third down and four.
So big third down here. Have to convert. Still inside your own 50 if you're the Titans. Schmitanka rolling right, looking for London, has him. It'll be a first down. And a good look there from Schmitanka to find his guy.
Never a bad idea to throw it to London, even though when he sometimes other tight ends would be covered. He wasn't. Big body in the middle, gets a catch, and gets the first down.
And I'm not saying Brandon London kind of scares me a little bit when he stands up and takes a bunch of those hits, but, man, sometimes you just got to wonder how many of those can he keep taking.
Gom listed 6'3", 255. He's certainly a big boy.
And now they hand it up to Razo, up the right side. Tackle's actually going to bring him forward a couple of yards. It'll be a gain of six on the play.
Now, the first time in a little bit, you see the blocking really open up lanes for Razo, and once he did, you saw he took advantage of it. A nice gain of six here to try to get the run game going again.
Razo, a very high runner in his stance, really keeps his chest and that ball pretty pinned up high to himself, really tries to not let the heads of the Spartans pop that ball out. So they give it to him again, and he gets tackled immediately line of scrimmage. Big tackle there from the Spartans. Brennan Knight again on it.
Razo, the ball carrier, stopped by Brennan Knight.
Yeah, he's been in the backfield repetitively so far. Titans have to do whatever they can to try to take him out of the game.
Again, Brennan Knight, 5'10", 235, the senior, making plays right now against the Titans. A third and three. It'll be a fumbled snap. Spartans think they have it. And they do. Another mistake, and who's on it? None other. Brennan Knight for the Spartans. And another mistake from the Shaler Titans. What is happening if you're the Shaler Titans?
Talked about the Titans need to be opportunistic on defense forcing turnovers, but that time Brennan Knight took matters into his own hands. Just talked about him in the last play, and now sees the ball on the ground and just dives on it. And once again, starting close with great field position. Now they're at their own 45.
Again, Shaler scoring 36 points a game right now, 109 points in the season. But right now, it is a rocky start for them. As Lippman's in the backfield in the shotgun, moving catcher to his right. Looking right. Pitches it over, London on the close. Catcher cuts back inside, gets a couple blocks, gets the first and more, and a great read from catcher to get that first down.
Yeah, the screen pass always has a potential for a huge gain, and that time they were able to get last drive, they tried to go to the left, this time they go to the right, and they might have found something there. That's going to be a Spartan first down.
And that's huge for the Spartans as we end the first quarter here at Spartan Stadium, where the Shaler Area Titans lead 6-3 over the Hempfield Spartans.
Let's go, Spartan Titans! You're watching SATV!
And welcome back to second quarter coverage of tonight's game, where the Titans lead 6-3 over the Spartans. Gonna wait for the referee to get set here. Head ref says we're good. Now Lippman in the shotgun. And look at this formation from the Spartans. It'll be a Lippman keeper looking for the outside, cuts back inside, gets past one, and he'll get the first all the way down inside the 30. And a Lippman keeper keeps this drive moving for the Spartans.
Yeah, very interesting formation. Two receivers on each side spread way to the sideline. That opened up some room for Lippman there, and he was able to take full advantage of it.
And now a three-man set down at the bottom, single man set up high to the top. Lippman takes the snap, looks for a quick pitch. It was to Batar, but we're going to have whistles blow it dead. It will be a false start on the Spartans.
False start on the offense, 5-yard penalty.
So it would have been a screen to Mitch Batar in his first reception on the night. Ends up in a penalty and a little breathing room now for the Titans, but you're not out of it just yet. Still first down.
Now a couple of big plays there. Lippman able to use his legs. And now that's something you got to keep worried about. He's probably been the most dangerous quarterback so far the Titans have seen when he can take down the ball and run.
And they're going to run that two receiver, one behind. Same formation again. Trying to spread the Titans out a little. Titans show blitz. Lippman looking for a change of pace maybe. Flip catcher over. They hand it off to him, looking to bounce out. Gets past the line of scrimmage. Or excuse me, no, he's going to be stopped a yard short. I thought his progression got him there.
The ball carrier stopped by 77.
So it'll be a second and 11 for the Spartans. And if you're the Titans, you have to hold here. You have to hold. You don't get the ball back to start the second half. And all the momentum right now, it's up in the air, but the Spartans are looking to grab it.
Interesting if they stay in that set. As it stands, you can't really see on your screen, but they're way out there. They're past outside the numbers. Now they're going to go into more of a traditional look here.
Now Littman takes the snap, feels the pressure, loads deep, looking for his man just out of the end zone and out of reach of his man, Ronald Catcher.
Yeah,
third and 11.
Tortorella on the coverage there. The receiver was very close to stepping out of bounds on the near side. The official was right on it, though, so it would have counted if he was in, but he did a great work of tiptoeing to stay in bounds, or else that would have been a flag.
And now a different change of pace. We saw the Titans really going into this hurry-up, quick-set offense. Spartans taking their time, knowing that they can take over in this second quarter right now with only 2 minutes not even gone.
Yeah, touchdown gives you the lead here if you're Hempfield.
Three-man set, Littman in shotgun. Signals Catcher in motion, looking right. Sees the pressure, evades it. Trying to find something, has to throw it away. And it'll be a flag on the Titans. Another penalty in the name of the Titans.
Yeah, Winters couldn't quite hold up there. Usually they give like a second, maybe a little less than that.
Flag on the play.
Close call, but this is going to hurt for sure.
And they're discussing if the Spartans want to accept it or not. And again, right now, this Titans side, from what we've seen so far this season, so disciplined, minimal flags thrown, and already five or six now.
Late hit on number eight.
It'll be a late hit. It'll be a first down. And if you're the Titans right now, you're kind of in shock.
Yeah, you've got to be careful. You know, that's the second time they've called that late hit, this time to roughing the passer. You just got to make sure you light up, be disciplined here. They're going to call it. And now we have a timeout to figure things out here for the Titans.
And if you're Jim Ryan, you got to bash some heads together and say, well, what are we doing? Let's go. Let's figure it out. Because right now, the Spartans are looking in prime position to take over. Right now, Nick Kiefer's saying to himself, he's licking his lips at the opportunity that he can go up here and score against a Titans team that's only allowed 10 points a game.
Interesting. The first-year coach taking over. Always hard for a new coach coming in. He's been there a long-time assistant his first year as head coach. And 1-2 start, but they can even things up here, get to 500 with a win. But you see Coach Ryan right now making his point clear to the defense. Got to get a stop here for sure.
And not just get a stop. Stop playing around and play the defensive side like we've been playing all year. Because right now, this is a Titans defense that we've been excited about. A lot of people in the Whipple have been excited about. Everybody's been saying this 10 points per game defense is holding strong. And right now, it's crumbling. It is crumbling right now. And now the Spartans are going to take the field with a first and 10. It'll be at the 15-yard line is where they're going to mark it.
Yeah, those five shallow penalties have been for 45 yards.
And while that may not sound like a lot, they are monumental where they have been. Littman looking right. Has a man. Good catch there. Stays on his feet and thrown down. But what a snag from Jack Kopis. The 5'10 sophomore making that snag.
Yeah, that was a great throw by the quarterback just over top of the Titan defender. And a great job by the receiver to bring it down. It'll be a second down and one.
And again, there were questions about Littman. I was questioning whether or not he would show up and be the quarterback that Hempfield needed tonight. And right now, he is. They're going to hand it off to Catcher with speed up the middle. He'll gain three. It'll be a It'll be a first down, yes.
The ball carry stopped by one. First and goal, Spartans.
So first and goal for the Spartans. They hand it off to catcher again, left side, and in for a Spartan touchdown. What a drive from the Hempfield Spartans, and they're making a statement.
Titans were able to stop them on the goal line last time. Not the case so far. Not the case this time, as they're able to take the lead now. 9-6, 10-6, pending the extra point.
And again, right now, this Titan offense and defense is, we wondered, were they going to come in and play like they've been here before? Were they going to be lackadaisical? What was the intensity? And right now, Hempfield's read it, and they've pounced. And Riley's kick is up and good in favor of the Spartans, who lead now over the Titans 10-6. And Matt, from what we saw in that first 2 minutes from the Titans, and now in the last, per se, 15 from the Spartans, it's been all Spartans, in my opinion.
And it starts in the trenches. The Shaler's offensive line has been so good all year. They've been beat often so far. And on the opposite side, their defensive line has done a slightly better job. That being said, they allowed the touchdown there. And now, if the Titans haven't woke up already, they definitely have now.
And you have to wonder who's going to step up. Who's going to be the one guy that says, guys, we're 3-0 right now. We're looking to go 4-0 for the first time in forever, maybe before many of us were walking, right? So if you are the Spartans, you're saying we have a chance. Again, said it in pregame. This could be an upset so far of the first half of the season. Again, this is a top-ranked team right now in 5A, the Shaler Titans. Knock them off here. You go into the confidence game. Again, not an easy schedule for the Spartans as they head next week into Penn Trafford, Gateway, and Seneca. That's their next three. What a rough next three that could be. Now Riley, good boot. It'll be DiSabato inside his 10. Looking to cut up left, and a bunch of Spartans cuts back inside and thrown out at the 15.
Now there is a flag at the 36, another one thrown at the 20. Let's see, there are going to be a couple of penalties for sure.
I've got a feeling one could be blocking the back or holding.
Don't know what the one could be at the 36.
Brendan Knight right now on your screen saying, all right, I think this was a block in the back.
Illegal block in the back, 51 on the return team. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
And another penalty in name of the Titans. And the Spartans hyping up their crowd saying, let's go, get fired up.
Yeah, that's their sixth of the night now, and we're not even out of the first half yet. Only 9:27 left in the first half, but they've got to figure things out. And what you don't want to do is that, and now you're starting inside your own 10-yard line.
And if you're the Titans, you have to respond accordingly. You can't let this slip out of your hands right now. Spetanka, shotgun, feels the pressure, has to scramble, getting chased, gets passed for a couple of yards. Actually, a great take by Spetanka on the scramble. It'll be 5 or 6.
What a phenomenal play by Spetanka. Hempfield was thinking they might have been able to get a safety there with him dropping back, but Spetanka keeps his cool. And able to get a fantastic gain and turn what could have been a negative play into a nice positive.
Yeah, we saw last year and the year before, Spetanka struggling a little bit, deciding what to do, throw it away, keep the ball. Right now, keeping his wits and keeping that drive alive. They hand it off to Razo up the middle. He'll gain 2.
Razo's ball carrier stopped by Lipton.
So something I see in your notes there is that Hempfield's rush defense has been subpar so far throughout the season, but right now it definitely looks like they've stepped up their game.
I think if you looked in this week and you said, all right, Nate Razo, not a guy that's scoring a lot of touchdowns, only 2 on the season so far, getting a lot of yards. We stop him, we can work our way back up. Spetanka looking right, has his man DiSabato trying to make yards after the play, still on his feet somehow. And a little ballerina spinning act there from Joey DiSabato to gain a couple of yards after the catch.
He's just so elusive and so hard to tackle. You tell us that they're backing off of him a little bit because you know how dangerous he is once he gets the ball in his hands. That run after catch is a big part of his game.
And it's got to be frustrating a little bit if you're Joey DiSabato saying, come on man, please, I'm going to burn you. But again, giving him the space that the Spartans want. Spetanka on the scramble left. Cuts it back up the middle, breaks a leg or two. Goodness me, Keegan Spetanka.
Spetanka once again on the screen.
Nice move here from Spetanka. Couple of plays now. Pocket collapses, able to get out of it. Offensive line doing just enough, and
gain of six,
not really particularly known as a runner, but when he has to, he can do it.
Yeah, Shmatanka right now on the Whipple, known as the guy who's been leading his team. High completion percentage, a lot of yards, almost at 1,000 so far in the season, but doing it with his legs right now. Takes the snap, loads deep, has a man. Disa Battle has the catch, and that's what the Titans needed. Joey DiSabato inside the 40, moving the chains for the Titans.
That's one of those chunk plays you love to see. DiSabato beating his man, and exactly as you said, John, he's saying, give me the ball. Great job there, and that's a huge Titan first down.
And that's what they needed to get things started here again.
Correctly if I'm wrong, John, but I think it's the first time they've been in Hempfield territory since the opening drive.
I believe so, too. Loading deep again. And just dropped, was looking for Caden Orga. Would have been a touchdown if he caught it, an incomplete pass.
That was good coverage on the play by catcher. That throw was pretty good. And that Orga, if he had that ball again, you'd definitely think, I got to come down with that.
You have to in that situation, especially down four right now. And again, a lot of momentum not in your favor. Getting a little bit back after that DiSabato catch, but you're not really riding the wave like you're used to.
Regardless, a couple of times now Titans have looked to go deep. Maybe that'll stretch the defense and set up something underneath.
Shmatanka takes the snap. Quick pitch out to London. Gets stopped and somehow still on his feet. I mean, the kid just doesn't go down.
Such a big target. Another player on this Titans team that's hard to tackle. Once he gets the ball, like there's a little tight end flat there.
And the Spartans are going to take their first time out, saying now with a third and seven, you know, all right, we're not in the worst place right now. They're not in the red zone, but they're still dangerously, you know, it's the Titans right now. You're still playing against them.
Yeah, now with a third down and seven, you want to at least get close here to set up a fourth down and short. You likely go for this. You're down by four.
Yep.
Touchdown gives you the lead. Extra point would make it a three-point advantage in your favor.
And again, right now, where do you go to if you're the Titans? And if you're the Spartans, you're saying, all right, Brennan Knight's been absolutely balling right now for you. Littman's been making plays on the defensive side. Both catchers making plays. I mean, right now, the Spartans' defense is clicking. Can the Titans get their gears working again and get back into the red zone and get their points back on the board?
He just put the ball in Spetanka's hands. He's had a nice drive here, rebounding from a couple of drives ago. And now you're just going to take a look and just throw the open receiver.
And Shmatanka got to keep his wits on this play. Razo to his left, third and seven. Looking left, now looking right, has to scramble. Cuts back right, has a man, London. Was short of the first down.
Interesting to see. They're going to stop him inbounds.
They're going to say he only got to the 29. I thought he was a little bit in front of that when he first initially made the catch. But it'll be a fourth and three now for the Titans.
Thinking of Brandon here keeping the offense on the field.
And again, a smart play here by Jim Ryan. No need to go for a field goal when you can maybe just get the first, and they do to Joey DiSabato. Still on his feet. Cuts back inside. And the acrobatic Joey DiSabato doesn't just keep this drive alive. He keeps the chain moving and into the red zone.
That's a really big play here in the early going here in the second quarter. And they didn't waste too much time getting up to the line. They saw the look they wanted, and immediately, bam.
And again,
DiSabato, first down, keep the drive going.
The Spartans have eyes on Joey DiSabato at all times. Again, tied for second in the Whipple interceptions with 21, 246 yards on the season, two touchdowns, and still hasn't played four quarters this year in the first two games. Shmatanka loading left, looking for his man Orga, just out of reach again. Would have been a four-short touchdown if it was in the hands of Caden Orga. And Shmatanka wants that one back, and you know he does.
Yeah, great route there from Orga. Just a half step too far from him on that play. Lucky enough, though, it's still second down, and you're in the red zone. So scoring opportunity for the Titans.
Haven't seen Razo really get the call as of recent. Been all Schmetenka in his arm. Will Razo maybe get the call here and chunk up a couple of yards? Schmetenka's going to hold. Scramble left. Has a lot of space in front of him. Puts up a floater for Orga. Inbounds. No, incomplete. They're going to say one of his feet were out of bounds. And incomplete. Just couldn't keep his momentum in the end zone. And another look and another incomplete pass that could have been a touchdown from Schmetenka to Orga.
Yeah, we don't have instant replay up here, but I think what the official saw was his right foot was standing out of bounds.
Yep.
If he were able to just stand on one foot, he would have had it. But
do a little flamingo pose and maybe bring that in. Would have been a touchdown. No timeouts from either coach now. Under six remaining in the half. Schmetenka with time. Feels the pressure, runs on his feet, cuts back inside. A flag thrown, spin. We're going to have a flag. And it's against the Titans, I believe.
I think he got the first down. This will probably come back, judging by the spot where the flag was
thrown. It looks like a yard short of the first, but I think it's coming back. And I think it was in a hold against the Titans. I think the Titans know it.
10-yard penalty.
And another brutal penalty for the Titans after such a smart Schmetenka run that would have set up what could have been a first down if they marked it, or a fourth and one, whatever it would have been. It would have been inside the five regardless. So what would have been a fourth and one or a first down now is a third and – they think they're going to do a third and 15. It'll be a third and 20, excuse me.
Spetangas looks dangerous at a runner. In all likelihood, another pass here.
A lot of space in that backfield right now. Only two men in coverage in the safety area for the Hempfield Spartans.
Yeah, look how deep the safeties are playing right now. The one's creeping up a little bit, but one guy's standing far back of the 10.
Spartans blitz. Quick pitch off to Razo. Looking to bounce out. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage, and it'll be a 4th and 10 situation for the Titans. And what does Jim Ryan and his team decide to do here? Do we go for points? We are going to have a Spartan down on the field. We're going to take an injury timeout here, and we'll come back after this. Oh, hold on. He's back on his feet. Maybe not just yet. We need an injury timeout. Obviously, they're going to send the trainers out. That's Reddick Catcher, one of the three that we've been talking about tonight. Unfortunately, we haven't said his name too much. It's unfortunate the first time we've really said it was an injury, but he's able to walk off the field on his own power, which is good.
So fourth down 11 here. The ball at their 15. Interesting call. You could merits on both sides here. We'll see what Jim Ryan and the Titans are going to do here.
It's a real brain picker right now if you're the Titans. You're really not getting those completions you need, and your run game's not the most immaculate. And obviously, it's a 4th and 11. So where do you go here? Throw, most likely. A run would be very improbable unless it's a Schmetenka scramble, per se.
Orga's gotten open a couple of times. But I mean, you got to look for the end zone here. You could get a first down to the 4.
And they're going to have Littman drag back into the middle of the field. Schmetenka looking left. Has a man across the field. No call just yet. They're going to say he caught that. Wow, what a haul, Caden Orga. And it's going to move things into a hurry-up for the Titans, a first and one, and a possible scoring opportunity. Schmetenka on the push. And he's in for the touchdown. The Shaler Titans get the touchdown they've been wanting for the last 15 minutes of play, and they take the lead over the Spartans on a drive-saving catch from Caden Orga.
What a great play by Caden Orga, rolling over, and then there's just like, taking no chances, go to the bread and butter here, QB sneaks, Schmetenka for 6.
I mean, he's the guy right now. If you say, hey, we need a drive-saving play, we need a first down, right now it's Caden Orga.
So this is Mark Povich now on the extra point.
That ball is up, and it is good as can be for Mark Povich.
Kick is up.
So now the Titans lead 13-10 over the Spartans with 5:01 remaining. And for the Titans, you can finally maybe take a sigh of relief. Maybe at best.
Well, you can take a sigh, but now you got to come out and get a stop now on defense. That's a very important drive to get back in the lead. Not in the driver's seat yet. You've made your way from the back. Now you're in the passenger's seat. Got to move your way to the driver's seat. Got to get a stop here. 5:01 left to go. If you can stop them quickly, you can get another chance to maybe make this a two-score game.
Yep, again, they kick off to start the second half, so if they can stop the Spartans and maybe put a couple more points on the board, that would be ideal for the Titans. But it comes down to how does their defense play and how does their discipline hold? Because right now, that discipline has been pretty lackluster.
Been a lot of flags. Hemphill, I think, only has one penalty to Shaler's 7.
That's an unreal stat.
7 1/2, you don't see that from a Coach Ryan team.
No, you do not. A fumbled and bobbled kickoff attempt. And the Spartans will just fall on it at the 17-yard line. As the Spartans take the field with 5 minutes exactly remaining in this half. Libman and his offense trying to take over.
Some unfortunate to get the ball back after the muffed kickoff.
Libman looking left. Has a screen, it'll be caught, but a big booming hit there. Goodness me, Caden Orga. Put the spear down.
Littman's pass complete to 22, Lucas Orga.
It'll be a big tackle for loss.
That all started from pressure up front, and once he saw that, that's the only way you can go. Caden Orga saw the eyes of the quarterback, and he took off. What a hit by Caden Orga. The huge catch on fourth down, now on defense, making a big play there.
He was looking for Lucas Moore, Littman was. But Orga laid the boom, leaving a 2nd and 16 for the Spartans. They move more in motion, has to dump it across, and ball's out, it'll be a fumble. Do the Titans have it is the question. And I think the Spartans just followed right back on it.
I think you can kind of feel the tide starting to change. A couple of these plays now after the touchdown have gone for little to no gain. So the loss here to gain a yard back. And now this would be a nice stop for the Titans, get the ball back and a chance to score before half.
Yep, 3rd and 14 now after that LaPinto catch and almost fumble. Titans show blitz, they don't jump. It'll be, I believe, a false start actually now on the Spartans. I don't believe the Titans jumped across the line of scrimmage.
False start.
And it will be. That's a huge penalty in favor of the Titans. So unfortunate for the Spartans, how you've just talked about that 7-1 penalty differential now for the Spartans to get their 2nd at a time like this for a 3rd and 19, that's huge.
I think he tried the hard count there, but he got his own guy.
I haven't been able to figure out the hard count yet, and I've been doing this for how long now, Matt?
I don't know.
I am ancient, my friend.
6 years?
6 years, super senior. So now Littman. In the shotgun, moves Moore over. Looking right, quick screen to Moore. Winters on the close, Moore on his feet. But it'll only gain around 4 or 5.
Did the ball come out there at the end?
Winters thinks that it could have been the Titans, but either way, it'll be a 4th and 14.
Yeah, it looks like his elbow hit the ground for sure, but exactly what you need to do to the Titans. You have enough time now. 3 minutes and counting to get the ball back and try to get some points.
That's exactly what you need. If you can go down and get another touchdown, make it a two-score game, put yourself back in the driver's seat, that'll be huge. And now Riley pinned back at his own goal line. Good snap, good hold. It'll be a high boot, a lot better than the last one. And a safe catch by Orga. And man, it's always got to be a little scary if you're a punt returner where you see two defenders come up right on you and they're not going to touch you, but it's got to be a little worrying to grab that one and hold it.
Yeah, Orga, DiSabato, whoever's been back there on the punt returns, they've been doing this for 3 years now.
Four if you've been all the way back in 2020.
Yeah, for the time they got there when they were freshmen, but they've been giving this, a lot of these guys, 4 years, and the senior leadership, these guys have really helped to turn the program around and now have themselves with an opportunity here to stretch the lead 13-10 right now, make a two-score game if they can put one in the end zone.
Three-man set, Spartan show blitz they do. Schmatenka looking deep, loading a man across. DiSabato, 5, touchdown. Bread and butter for the Shaler Titans. First play on the possession, and you couldn't ask for more of a gift like that than the Shaler Titans just gave.
Catcher has had some good coverage, not on that one. Di Sabato too fast, fake to the right just a little bit, and then that seam route split the defenders, and he was off. What a play by Di Sabato.
And you got to be a little bit happier now if you're the Titans saying, hey, we haven't been able to make things work a little bit, but first play on the possession from inside your own 50. Goodness me. And now Povich to put things up. And again, 2 for 2 on the night. And I'll give a little shout out, former SATV commentator Mark Povich puts 2 for 2 on the night. A little proud moment there for us SATV people. 2:32 remaining in this half. Titans lead 20-10 over the Spartans. Matt, what have you seen now when you just said the you felt the tide shift? Not only have they shifted, now it's looking like the Titans have all the momentum again.
Well, just adjustments. And you see the couple of timeouts there. While they might not be strategic in terms of saving them for like a 2-minute drive, they are good just to settle things down. Like, okay, here's what they're doing. What can we do to change it? See it on the defensive side there in the last drive. In these last two possessions from the Titans, you see they're able to give Spetanka enough time. Blocking adjustments, then Spetanka's done a good job of stepping up in the pocket, then delivering the ball to open receivers.
And Spetanka's done an awesome job of knowing when to step up and throw and knowing when to scramble. He's felt the pressure so well, and that's what's helped the Titans get this score back on the board. So now a return from the Spartans. Can they get a good one here up the middle? Takes a booming shot from Tortorella. Still a good return from his goal line nonetheless, up to the 26.
Stopped by Troy Cignetti.
Cignetti actually gets credited with the tackle there. Troy Cignetti, a special teams player of the league last week for the Titans, obviously awarded him from the Titans, but again, nonetheless, another Cignetti making a name for himself.
Yeah, now Titans on defense, 2:25 left. That's enough time for them to mount a drive, but if they get a stop here, they can go into halftime with a 20-10 lead. And you've got to make sure you contain Lippman in this dangerous Hempfield offense.
Yep, what's worked best for this defense is making Lippman panic. No one up at the top of the field for the Spartans.
All their skilled position players on the near side of the field.
Now Lippman gets sacked in the backfield. Nate Razzo! A huge sack for the Titans. And what did we just say? Get the Lippman, make them panic, and the Titans do that right away.
Although he didn't have time to panic. He didn't see him coming.
No.
Just come up behind him like, well, nice knee.
Like the Sandman just came right behind him, tackled him, and put him into the ground. Textbook play from Razzo. And now it's 2nd and 18, a loss of 8. And there will be a single man to the top. Lippman takes the snap, hands it off. Moore on the take. And he'll gain 6 on the play. It might actually give him a little bit more. Made a last minute stretch at the end. He got 8 actually, so at a 3rd and 10.
Big third down for this Titans. If you can get a stop here, get him off the field. Just over 1:20 left.
So now Lippman trying to command his team and get back into the scoring that they need. Looking for more left, pitches it off. Razzo tries to cut him off, getting chased down. And finally wrapped up after gaining a couple. It was Troy Cignetti in on that tackle Lippman behind on Moore. So it'll be a 4th and 6 Cignetti. And with 50 seconds and counting
fourth
going down.
Six.
They're actually going to punt here. I actually thought that they might consider going for it, but I guess you're inside your own 31-yard line. Probably not worth it at this point in the game.
And that's the right call. You don't want to give Spetanka the ball with one or two chances to take a heave to the end zone. And although you're down by 10, Hempfield should be at least somewhat okay with their performance in the first half. They have given up 20 points, but they scored 10, and they have had the lead.
Yeah, they've had the lead for, I think it was a couple, 3 minutes at the time. I mean, that's a little bit, you know, here or there. But, I mean, for the Spartans, you got to be a little bit impressive, and it's unfortunate that on the first play of the Titans' last possession, it was a touchdown.
Yeah, but close doesn't cut it if you're Hemphill.
Absolutely. And again, the Titans take a smart timeout there. It'll be 43 seconds remaining on the clock, so that's actually going to stop. That clock would have ran down to about 30 seconds, I believe. So now this punt and this hold, you know, saying that Orga, whoever's back there to return, holds on to this thing. If it gets only to around the 50 or 40-yard line, the Titans still have around 40 seconds to maybe get this thing down the field.
It probably depends how good this return is. This could set up what the Titans do on their drive here before the end of the first
and
half.
And snap matters. Snap's good. Hold good. Punt is good. It'll go left out of bounds, actually. And that might actually be inside their own 50 for the Spartans. Oh, they're going to move it way up. They're going to move it all the way to the what would have been the Spartan 46. So now this can be prime still for the Titans.
Interesting decision to punt out of bounds. You know you don't want to have a punt returned on you, but at the same time, you've given them 35 seconds.
And inside your own half. They just scored from this play. This is the same spot that the Titans were just in on that Joey DiSabato touchdown. If you're Jim Ryan, are you saying, hey, we're going for it? Are we scoring here? Or are we saying, all right, let's just maybe pick at him a little bit. Brandon London's going to come out, sub out.
You can see both angles, but maybe on first drive you take a shot and see what happens. You never know, though.
No need to force anything if you're the Titans. Absolutely no need. They'll go to a three-man set up top, Bellis at the bottom. Fatanka takes the snap shotgun, looking left. A lot of time, has a man, Bellis. Oh my goodness! Just out of the fingertips of TJ Bellis, would have been in the red zone.
I think we got a flag. That might be a hold or pass interference. Let's see. Because that was
close. I'd be surprised if it's a hold on TJ Bellis with the separation he got initially.
I mean on Hemphill.
Oh, yes. Wow.
15-yard penalty. Touch in the first down.
And only 6 seconds off the clock. So 29 seconds remaining. And it is now a first and 10 at the 31.
If you're the defender, you had to do something there. Because if Bellis held onto that, first
would have
the clock
been at the 15.
Stops. And yeah, he might have been gone potentially if he couldn't tackle him.
So now the Titans still in a great spot here to put points on the board. Even a field goal try wouldn't be a bad idea here.
And we'll see. They've been rolling with Povich. He doesn't quite have the leg of Douglas, but you probably have to get a little bit closer.
Hard count from Shmatenka. Has to scramble right. Gets it off. Found Caden Orga, who stops the clock with 23 seconds remaining. And I thought Shmatenka threw it away.
That was a really smart play by Smetanka. Initially, you look to the eyes of the sidelines, like, I'll probably just throw this away.
Yeah.
But then out of the corner of his eye, says, oh, wait, he's open. I'm just going to throw him.
I mean, that's
right,
unbelievable.
Out of bounds. Really smart play by Smetanka.
Unbelievable from Keegan Smetanka. The maturity from him from previous seasons to now, unrivaled. Unrivaled. And now he gets the look again. High fade into the corner and just out of reach. Titans want a flag. But it looked a little bit uncatchable for TJ Bellis. Bellis, excuse me.
He looked at him again and didn't quite get enough separation from his defender, you think. He tried to maybe
just
push off a little bit.
Just over the backside of his head, just out of reach.
If he made that catch, we would have gone nuts.
I mean, you could make a highlight tape if he caught that for Titan catches of the season, which could have been Whipple catches of the season. I mean, you've already got three so far this year.
Yeah, all from Caden Orga.
Yep. Clock still at 18. Design scramble left. And it'll be a completion. It was the Peyton Plans.
Clock still running. No way they stopped it at 8. A couple extra seconds came off the clock here.
And 6 remaining.
Downs the ball.
So now 6 seconds remaining. A 2nd and 10 from the 17. And honestly, I thought that ball was... I thought that was an interception almost for the Spartans. It looked like it was going to Orga, went past to Spartan, and got the plans.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell from that this angle we have right now.
I was ready to call an interception, but he found his man. And we're going to go for the field goal here for the Titans. Mark Povich is going to step up here, try and put another three on the board for the Titans. It'll be a 34-yard attempt. Good snap, good hold. Kick is up. And he got it. Povich puts three on the board. Clock expires. And the Titans go into the half leading 23-10 over the Spartans. So with that, enjoy the halftime performances from the band and join us here for second half coverage of tonight's game.
23, Spartans.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in welcoming the Pride of Shaler Area, our award-winning Titan Marching Band. Tonight we bring the bright lights of Broadway to the field. We will feature the songs Dancing Through Life and Defying Gravity from Wicked, I Have a Dream and Mamma Mia, and One Day More from Les Mis, featuring soloists Owen Yarnott, Josh Offen, Eddie Schmidt, Michael Ulrey, and Donna Gill.
Thank you.
assistant directors Kristen Tepsich, Kelly West, and Ryan Kitzler. Field tech Michael Abella, dance team sponsor Amanda Vigilotti, majorette sponsor Alyssa Ryan, color guard sponsor Becky Butler, pit tech Casey Berg, and drumline sponsor John West. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Sophia Hayes and Carrie Yarnott, dance team captains Elena Flavin and Ali Polziani, and drumline captains Connor Smith and Elise Williams. The band thanks you for your kind attention this evening. We would also like to thank our band boosters for all of their hard work and dedication.
And welcome back to second half coverage of tonight's game. Hopefully you enjoyed the impressive performances from the bands, but John Irwine and Matt Perucker back up here for coverage of tonight's game, and what a half that was, Matt.
So, tale of two quarters, really two time periods, not exactly in the first quarter, but what the Titans were able to do is they were able to respond. They did not let their somewhat below average play stop them, and again, got 17 unanswered points and really helped to take the lead. 13-point lead now, 23-10 coming out of halftime.
Yeah, absolutely. 23-10, obviously helpful with that field goal at the end of the half and from Mark Povich. A couple of stats from the Titans. Keegan Svitenka, 18 of 24, 194 yards, two throwing touchdowns to London and DiSabato, one rushing touchdown, and a good bit of yards on his feet. Joey DiSabato, one touchdown himself, 105 yards in receiving. Now Riley Douglas will get us underway here in second half of tonight's game. On the return, taking it back, looking up the middle, gets a block, but is going to get dragged down. So a good return from catcher. And it'll only get back just inside the 30. Now, Matt, let's talk real quick. Again, tale of two quarters, like you said. That first quarter, that first 2 minutes, we thought Shaler's game to lose. That's what it almost seemed like. It felt like you scored in the first minute and a half. It was impressive as can be. And then it was Spartans for the next 15, and then in about 5 or 6 minutes, 17 points unanswered.
Yeah, and for Hemphill, then they get their first drive on here in the second half. They got to get some of that momentum back. Let's see what they do.
And they hand it up the middle to catcher, still on his feet, a bunch of yards after the first initial touch. Gets all the way up. It'll be a 7-yard gain. So great first take for him.
The catcher, big physical runner, and that's what you want to see there if you're Hemphill. A hard-fought 9 yards run on that play.
And they're going to give it back to him up the middle. Bounces outside, gets past Tortorella, puts his head down, and gets across the 50, and a hot start for the Spartans. And that's what they need. That's what we said they needed to do, and that's what the Titans needed to stop because, again, it was pretty, I wouldn't say lackluster, but the intensity was so different from the Spartans to the Titans in that first quarter. And they're going to give it to the catcher again, but he's dragged down for a tackle for loss. A great tackle there. Sammy Tapu stepping in for Carson Pierce and making a big play right there.
Great pursuit on that play. He knew immediately he was going to tackle him from the waist. Great job there, and that's going to be a loss of two.
Again, the 6'1", 205 freshman making plays right now, stepping in for that injured Carson Pierce, one of the defensive leaders on the Titans.
Yeah, always hard as a freshman having to step into a situation like this, but he has shown that he belongs with this mainly senior-led group.
And the Titans showed blitz there initially. Got an audible from his sideline. Littman takes the snap, looks right, feels the pressure, and it takes a big hit, and he's going to get a big loss on the sack there. That's a huge sack.
Rosso, his second sack of the day. And a couple of defenders got in the backfield for the Titans. Able to get out of it quickly there. It was Littman, but he didn't see Rosso. And Rosso, once again, able to grab him and take him down.
Yep, and I think Littman initially was looking for Mitch Batar, was really just trying to find him cutting across the middle of the field, but just couldn't get it out. Didn't feel Rosso coming in on the pressure and took a sack. So a 3rd and 17 now, under 10 minutes. Titans show a shade of a blitz. They do. Pressure on the backside of Littman, has to scramble wide open but dropped. That is an unfortunate drop there. That would have been in pace and in stride, could have been a first down, was looking for Ronald catcher, and wasn't able to haul it in. He had miles of space.
I think there was a situation there where the pressure influenced Littman just enough to the point where that throw was not quite on the money, and then catcher wasn't quite expecting the ball to be that high. And that
was
probably
why
he dropped
it.
It
was on
a zip,
too. It was very quick paced of a throw.
You could tell he was getting a little nervous as he was throwing that.
Now Josh Riley again has to get a good boot. Gets it out. It is high. Into the lights and out. No, actually not out of bounds. It bounces now out at the 30. So now the Titans will take over at the 30-yard line. And this is now where if you're Jim Ryan and the Titans, you get a four and out. And you say to yourself, all right, we're up 13. Our first quarter wasn't the best of, you know, we've ever had. That first minute and a half was awesome. But that last 6-7 minutes in the second quarter, you've got to replicate that right now. That intensity, that drive is what you need.
And that's what they've shown so far is what they showed last week, that resiliency. You're not going to go out there and obliterate every opponent you face, no matter how good you are. And they just got to keep the momentum going. First drive of the second half, let's see what they can do.
Now Schmatankis takes the snap, gives it to Razo, gets a gap up the middle, kind of towards the left, gains a lot of yards, though. And again, Razo again, making plays on both sides of the ball, two sacks on the night, a bunch of yards, and just pushing the Titans down the field. That's all you can ask for him right now.
Yeah, 8-yard gain. Kept the legs moving, pushing for a couple extra yards, and credit to the offensive line. They opened up that gap for him.
And again, we said it earlier, these Spartan, the safeties and coverage are pushed up so far. And it's actually a fake screen. Razo up the middle, gets past one, got dragged down a little by his jersey number and gets into the Hemphill Spartans territory and inside the 40.
Yeah, Reddick catcher just got enough of the jersey there to slow him down. And if he was able just to get by so close, inches perhaps, from a rocket touchdown.
And again, he's working so hard. At this point, you got to think he deserves to be on that scoreboard tonight. But right now, I think he's happy making the plays he's making.
Glad to finally see the running game go. And they've relied a lot on the pass, and you can't throw it every down. So great to see Razo here as they give it to him again.
And bounces outside. And again, still after the first initial tackle, is able to gain three.
Razo, the ball carrier, stopped by.
I mean, he's doing really well to get those extra yards after the initial tackle, which is so big at this level. I mean, to be able to get hit by someone and still get two or three more yards, that's huge. That's drive-saving yards.
But you can tell he's not afraid of contact,
no,
for sure.
No, absolutely not. Putting his head down. Again, not the biggest running back ever in the Whippeel, right? 5'10", 205. But he'll put his head down and run three if he gets the opportunity. Now Schmatanka looking right. Time in the pocket. Has to scramble. Gets away from one. Cuts back in. Feels the pressure and takes a sack in the backfield on the scramble. A bunch of Spartans feeding into the pressure, and they got to him eventually. Jackson Humes gets there eventually and puts Schmatanka down.
I'm somewhat surprised he didn't throw it away there. A couple of times, at least three or four times in that first half, he was able to escape under pressure and turn into a positive game. That time, he thought he saw open space, but in fact there wasn't any, and then he took a sack. That's not exactly what he wanted to do here. It sets up a third down long.
Yeah, it's something you don't see much from Schmatanka. You see him know when to throw it away. I think maybe he just thought he had a little bit more space from Humes. So now the Spartans, can they get there again? The pitch to Tortorella, trying to bounce out, doesn't get tripped up, but he only gets back to the line. He got stopped pretty much right to where the line was. And it's going to be a 4th and 14 now. And they're going to punt. So wacky couple of plays there from the Titans.
Yeah, usually you don't see Matenga take a sack like that. And that's Tortorella's first carry of the game. So interesting how they're using him so far as the kicks away.
And now Douglas's punt. It'll be a good one. For the punting standards we've had tonight, we do have a flag on the field. The ball bounced out around the 16-yard line. We've got a flag at the Hemphill 43.
I think that's going to be on Shaler. McKay took someone out after the play. So, not had a penalty for a while for the Titans, but
just too many.
That was a theme for the first half, and that's something that they do not want to see repeated.
And you got to say to yourself, you're the Titans, we've had way too many, and they just come at the worst times.
Personal foul on the receiving
team. Oh, wow.
Receiving team. Wow.
Okay.
Guess I got the first guy. I missed it.
That's a 15-yard penalty.
So
wow!
That changes my whole point entirely.
Goodness me, they went at the snapper. Okay, I have not seen that called in a long time, if ever. I don't think I've ever seen a penalty where they made an infraction with the snapper.
Yeah, and I thought it was something I have to play because they threw that flag really late.
Yes, that was after the ball had gone pretty much at its peak height.
So that was very interesting. I haven't seen that either, John. That's
Well, that's a gift for the Titans right now. They get to take back over.
Exactly what you do not want to do if you're Hemphill right now. You got to try to claw back in this game, and that's not what you want to do.
If the Titans can put points on the board, this is going to hurt. And it'll be a get past Matenka. He's just going to have to fall on it. What was that from the Titans? A man in motion, and the snap just went to the right.
Eswine's been pretty solid all year with his snaps, but that time, that's the second time now he's had one get away from him. The first time resulted in a turnover was that snap that went like about 1 foot behind him.
And I believe it was Jordan Winters in motion, and the ball almost went to Jordan Winters in the snap. So now the Titans again, a second and 30, and they were just, now they're back to where they kind of just were.
Titans hoping this is not a repeat of that first quarter.
Now Shmatenka with time. Bounces back. Look at the time he has, but now has to scramble and throw it away. He had a lot of time. No one could just open and free up.
Di Sabato and Orger were open deep, but there was no way he was going to throw that running backwards to his right. London kind of got open there at the end, but I think it was the right call for Smetanka just to throw it away.
So now a third and 30 and a quick 6 minutes off the board. 5:45 remaining in the third. I mean, I feel like the quarter just started. The Titans still up 13 on a third and 30 right now. Takes the snap. They hand it off to Razo. He gets speed, but he only gets a gain of 6 at the most. And it is going to be 6. So a 4th and 24. They're going to go hurry up, line it up.
4th and 24.
Great call there. Don't want to turn it over when you have a 13-point lead.
And no need to take a sack either. Be a good snap. Boots good. Does it stay? It's going to get caught. And he's getting a bunch of hits. Winters and Tapu still on his feet. Catcher on the return. He only, with his forward progress from where he caught it, was only at the 7-yard line.
That was interesting. That's the second time now that the punt returner has not called for a fair catch. Luckily, he didn't get laid out either time. But you think it would have just been easy for him just to take the catch, not have to worry about being tackled.
From where he was as well, it was just an interesting decision. Not a bad one per se. I mean, with the forward progress, but you didn't make any yardage from where you caught it. And now they're backed up inside their own 10.
So despite the personal foul on the punt last time when Shaler had the punt, they get the ball back without being down any further.
And look at this, no wide receivers. They have 3 running backs. And I think we're gonna have an early timeout. And after that little substitution from the Hemphill Spartans, I think Nick Kiefer is a little upset because right now I think he had the wrong personnel that was out there. And yeah, and he's laying into his guys a little bit saying, hey, we need to pick it up. We're still down 13. We only have 17 minutes left in this game. We got to pick it up, and it has to start now.
Yeah, the coach is way out there. He's in the huddle right now. You see him right now. And
it's good to see that he's out there giving his team the instructions, saying, hey, I'm with you guys 100% of the way, but you got to be with yourselves. You have to fight this battle. It's not a tough hill to climb. It's a 2-score game for sure, but with a lot of time left in the game, anything's possible. Like you said, that's why you play the game.
And yeah, that timeout was twofold. First, The clock was going to hit 0 on the play clock. They didn't want to back themselves any further. And 2, didn't have the right personnel. Whatever was going to happen out of that play wasn't going to be any good.
So now let's see how they line up. They've got Brady Ewing to the left. Catcher behind. What do the Spartans pull here? They're going to give it to catcher up the left side, trying to bounce out, but he only gets to the line of scrimmage.
Rogan catches the ball carrier.
And a little twisting and turning. And we're going to have a flag on the play. Another flag. Goodness me, the yellow is out tonight. And I think it's going to be on the Spartans. And I think it's on catcher.
That play, personal foul.
It is on catcher, so a little bit of, you know, tanglement while you're down on the ground. Sometimes you get guys poking at each other, you know, trying to maybe pull a little ankle business or something like that, but catcher didn't have any of, or didn't want any of that to happen. Might have just given a little bit of a shove, and the ref saw it.
And that just comes from frustration, and that's what you don't want to do. I mean, you're down in your own end. You're down by 13. You're just hurting the drive before it could even get going.
And you could tell he was a little frustrated again because I think he was upset that he wasn't out there for the previous play. As he gets the call here, pushes the man over, still on his feet, and now catcher on a race. Can he get chased down on his high horse? Cross the 50, gets to the 30, and tripped up at the 20. And now catcher just made everything that just went wrong. He wiped it off the board. Put the Spartans inside the red zone in an instant.
Great hustle from Decent Battle running back. He nearly poked that ball three. He tried to punch it out. But regardless, it's a huge play for the Spartans. That's how you flip field position.
And what we thought was maybe going to be another out and another punt from the Spartans just turned into an instant scoring opportunity.
Now let's see how the Titans defense respond after giving up that big play.
Again, no receivers. They're going straight run game here unless they decide to switch it up. They'll go audible call here. Keeper is on the field by about 3 yards. He is into it right now. They're going to give it to Cat. No, it's a fake from Lippin. And he gets pushed out of bounds after the catch. It'll be a flag and a late hit on the Titans.
Flag on the play.
Wow. I didn't think he was necessarily that far out of bounds yet.
Well, even if he's out of bounds, technically they can still
throw
the flag.
Yeah, if he's making his way out of bounds, you have to let him get his space.
You have to be careful, yep.
So another penalty.
I'm starting to lose count of the amount of flags in this game, John. I'm having a hard time.
We might have to hire someone to start counting because I'm not.
Defense number 16. After the play, half the distance, first down.
Wow. So what a wacky 45 seconds of play we just had here. So now at the Titans 6, Hemphill can go and score here.
Titans hoping to stand strong here, deep in their own territory.
Lippman hands it to catcher, up the middle, still moving, gets inside the 2. And if you're the Titans, you cannot have frustration take over right now. You may be upset, you may be angry, you may feel calls are not going in your direction, but at the end of the day, you're still up 2 scores, and even if the Hemphill Spartans score, you still get the ball back.
Hey, gotta get a stop here for sure.
And if you're Hemphill, you are in prime position right now to make this, you're right back in this thing if you score. So let's see, Lippman. Takes the snap, gives it to catcher, and he gets stopped immediately in the backfield. He'll lose a couple of yards on the play. Winter's in on that one.
Catcher the ball.
Great penetration on that play. Two Titan defenders in there. Winter's able to get the tackle, then just march him back. They're really looking to attack via the ground game right now.
Yep, Jordan Winter's the 6'1", 190 senior. Got there, stopped him. Might open a couple things up now on the receiving side. And how does the coverage of the Titans hold with a 3rd and 5? Again, catcher's been dangerous right now.
They've run a lot of screens. Let's see what they do here.
No one up to the top of the side. They move catcher up, maybe as a blocker. Lippman's going to carry it himself with speed and in for the touchdown.
Touchdown,
Spartans. And Lippman leads his guys under the wings of catcher on that amazing run and gets 6 back on the board for the Spartans.
That formation, you could tell, was really good. Try to distract the defense, have 3 guys on your right, and then run the ball back to your left with that blocker. And was able to set up good blocks and get through the Titan defense for 6.
And the Spartans making it a close game. There's a lot of close games going on right now on the Whipple. Woodland Hills, North Hills, 7-7. Franklin Regional Gateway, 10-7 in favor of the Panthers. And right now, the Spartans make it 17-23, still in favor of the Titans with 2:43 remaining. And Matt, man, we thought this was all Titans to start. It has turned around quickly.
Well, two-score game, when you get that score, takes a one-score game, of course, and the drama increases further, especially with that missed extra point by Douglas in the first quarter after the opening drive touchdown. It's now only a six-point game. So you got to hope that missed extra point doesn't come back to haunt the Titans.
Yep, absolutely. And it matters for the Titans right now.
So they got to hope. Titans got to respond, regain that two-possession lead. That would be huge for them to try to sort of reestablish control that you saw at the end of the first half.
And if you're the Titans or the Spartans, but especially for the Titans, you got to stop seeing that yellow flag, because right now the Titans have 8 penalties for 80 yards, and all 8 of those penalties, I can say, have been at monumental moments in this game.
That is more yards than the rest of their games combined.
I mean, that's just an unreal stat.
That's just...
It's one of those games where you wish it could have been cleaner, but you got to clean it up at some point.
Got to clean it up, and might as well start now.
Now Josh Riley will boot this thing from the 40. Good pace. Decent battle will take it at his 10. Cutting back inside. Stays on his feet. Gets past Batar. And he gets all the way to the 25-yard line. But we'll have a Hempfield Spartan injured on his near sideline.
We are the Chandler Titans 2023 boys soccer team, and you're watching SATV.
Go Titans!
Shmatanka hands the ball off to Tortorella, trying to bounce out, cuts back inside, stays on his feet, and gets a good gain there. So now Tortorella getting some calls.
Did some good work there, splitting the two defenders, and it's always hard to try to tackle someone that's in between two of you. So he was able to use his burst of speed to pick up a nice gain there on first down.
And the change of personnel now to Torreya. I haven't seen Razo. I didn't think he went off with an injury or if he was fatigued or not, but I'd be surprised if they just decide to take Razo out of the game. They're going to give it to Torreya again. Bounces outside, but he's going to lose, I believe, a yard or only get back to the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Tortorella is that change of pace back, but one of the things that is not his strong suit is running north to south. He tried to cut it up to the outside, and no room was there, and he's going to be knocked back a couple yards. Let's take a look at the spot.
So it'll be a third and three. Razo is back in the game, so two plays to get a first here. Razo again, averaging around 6 yards per carry. And I believe we're going to have a timeout.
I have a flag at the 50.
Oh, we do have a flag. What is the flag on? Let's see.
Illegal substitution, defense.
Wow.
On the field, 5 yard penalty.
And I feel like, are we jinxing them at this point? I feel like we're jinxing them. I feel like every time we say we got to, you know, both teams have to stop having penalties and both teams, you know, can't have unnecessary mistakes. And right away, the chains get moved.
Yeah, just counting right after he threw that flag, I saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, they got to 12 guys on the field. So that's what you cannot do on third down.
Huge break for the Titans. Now they fake it to Razo. Shmatanka with time. London across and out of his hands.
Don't see him drop too many like that.
Just and I think he
couldn't
just
quite corral it in.
I think he just tried to pull it in too quick and try and make some yards after the catch. But again, you and I both know what the number one rule is, and I know they're going to hate when I say it, but got to catch that thing in first and then make the run. I know wide receivers, you're all out there. You hate me for saying that, but you all know it's true. You got to pull that one in. That's a huge catch if he pulls that one in. So now Shmatanka, 2nd and 10, shotgun. They give it to Razo, up the middle, and gets a good gain. Ball is out, but I think they're going to call him down.
Yeah, he was definitely down. The guy just smacked it out of his hand after the play.
Never hurts to get a little hand in there. Maybe the refs don't see it. So now it'll be a 3rd and 5. Same situation you were just in. You got the lucky break with a penalty, and now another Spartan is going to go down. So we'll bring the trainer out. And we'll go to an injured player. And now You just got to question things here. We're 47 seconds remaining in the third. This has been a quick quarter. I mean, not many stoppages other than, you know, one timeout taken from the Spartans. And a couple of injury timeouts, but man, I mean, if you're the Titans, where do you go from here? You know, you're up a touchdown, but only six. So if the Spartans go down the score, put the extra point through, you know, Riley's been on fire tonight. Where do you go from here right now? Third and five, what's your call?
You gotta take it just one play at a time. Third and five, it looks like a pretty long five. It's gotta be through the air, you gotta think. Trust your guy, Keegan Smetanka.
Can't afford a sack.
Don't wanna take a sack. You could maybe if you want to run it, if you really want to try to go for a fourth down, but even if you do, probably give your guy two chances to come up with a play for you.
Now let's see, two man set to the top. Tank a hard count. And we're going to have a flag again. It'll be a false start on the Titans. Goodness me, is this a game of flags.
Yeah, London, I saw just barely moved, and that was enough for the false start. But just so many penalties on both sides.
That's 10 on the night, I believe, for the Titans.
Yeah, that's in the double digits now. And what, it's got to be, I think, 100 total yards in penalties.
I think win or loss, whatever how this goes for the Titans, Jim Ryan is going to have a field day with penalties next practice for the Titans. Now Smetanka has time, finds a man across. It's London, gets to the 40.
That was a good tackle in open space, and now that's going to force the Titans to punt it away.
And now the Spartans, we said the tides were changing. I think they're making them go back in their favor. Under 10 remaining. Douglas is going to look to punt this thing. And we're going to have a flag for illegal substitution on the bottom of the field. A return right now from catcher. Cuts back inside, still on his feet. Gets to the 50, but we had a flag at the bottom of the field. I believe a Spartan got off late. I'm not sure if it was an illegal substitution or not, though. Clock has run out, but we've got to decide what happened here.
Yeah, that's usually what happens when you see a flag from the back judge way over there.
I believe he got out late. Now let's see, this is a big penalty decision here. And I think they're gonna ask the Titans what they wanna do. Just confirming, this is huge right now. As we're about to head into the fourth quarter again. And yep, I believe it's on the Spartans. Yep, they're gonna go ask what they wanna do here. And I think the Titans just got another break.
Yeah, past couple times for Hempfield not having the right personnel on the field, especially for a punt.
Substitution infraction, 12 on the field, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
So it's still fourth down because it was a fourth and six, so it's now a fourth and one.
And you'd like to think that brings the offense back on the field, right?
And I'm sighing because now it's a chess game. Where do you go from here?
See, fourth down and one, your own 45. Probably time to roll the dice, do you think, John?
Oh, it's tough. You're about to get one final play. Clock is stopped at zero. We are at zeros right now. They haven't just said to put any more time back on the clock.
Well, I forget what the rule is in high school when it stops at zero at the end of the third quarter. I think in the NFL they just switch it, but let's see.
Well, we got to see. Either we're going into a fourth quarter break right now.
Yeah, that's what the officials are trying to figure out, too. How much time's left on the clock, if any.
Do we go into a fourth quarter break?
To the fourth quarter? A lot of fun here from the officials.
I think the Titans, don't they get to decide, I believe? I think they get to decide if they want to go into the fourth or have a play, one final play in the quarter.
Well, let's see here.
Well, let's see.
The period ended during the play. With a penalty, we have one untimed down.
So it is an untimed down. Okay.
Wasn't quite sure of that, but yeah.
So the Titans get an extra play right now on a fourth and one. So this right now, heading into the fourth, what do they do? This has hurt my brain to think about right now. So many penalties, so many different things going on right now, and the Titans are going to go for it.
Big fourth down right now.
I am standing up right now. The Titans are going to go for it on a fourth and one. Imagine they get a hard count penalty here. Imagine. Orga at the bottom of your screen. Smetanka, hard count for sure. And it'll be a false start on the Titans. Unbelievable penalty from the Titans.
Yeah, Yekyll flinched there on the hard count, and now it's probably time to punt it away.
Fourth down.
So now it's a punt for the Titans.
Now, interesting, I don't think they were going to snap that no matter what, but...
It would have been nice to not...
But if you know you're going to do that going into it, why are you even moving?
So now Douglas, hopefully a better boot. It'll roll. And catcher will fair catch just in front of the 25. So now we head into the fourth quarter of play where the Titans lead the Spartans 23-17.
We're the 2023 Shale Area Golf Team, and you're watching SATV.
Yeah! And welcome back to fourth quarter coverage of tonight's game where the Titans lead the Spartans 23-17. 12 minutes left in this game to decide things.
Time for the defense to stand tall. Another false start. That's their 10th of the night.
90 yards.
So 10th penalty for 90 yards officially now.
The Spartans have 6 for 70, but I believe the Spartans just, they've come out unfortunate times, but not in the desperate situations that the Titans have had. So now Littman in the shotgun. Three receivers set. He's going to hand it off to Moore. Moore gets a gap. Puts an arm down, but gets dragged down by DeSabato with the 45, and it's the Titans' run defense starting to falter.
The ball carrier.
They're going to go quick here again, trying to gain some momentum.
Let's see, Littman, again, going to hand that thing off to Moore. Gets a good couple of yards. I believe he gets 4 or 5, depending on the spot.
For the ball carrier stopped by Barnhart, gain of 5, second and 5.
And again, the Spartans making a huge push right now. Put themselves back on top with a touchdown. They give it off again. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage where the ref was. So it'll be a third down and 4. Tackle by Tapu. So now the Titans needing a stop and the Spartans needing a first down. Titans don't jump, got very close to.
Interesting, three down linemen here for Shaler. A lot of guys in coverage.
Littman takes the snap, hands it off to Moore. He gets a first down up the middle with pace and gets more than that to the 30. Haven't had to said Lucas Moore's name that too much tonight. You've had catcher take a lot of the snaps and a lot of the, you know, appraise right now. But now Moore's taking his name and he's saying, hey, I'm still here too. Don't forget about me.
Great block by Wetterstein on that last play.
Now Littman again across. It'll be a quick out to Batar.
Littman's pass.
It'll be to the 25. It'll be a second and 6 situation now. And these Spartans are rolling. The Spartans are looking to upset the top 5 ranked in the Trib and in the Post-Gazette, Shaler Area Titans. Blitz from the Titans, Littman looking left. Do they get there? Has to get there. And they get to him. Ball pops out. Down nonetheless. And the Titans got to him. Ben Yekyll in on that one.
Yeah, him and Connor Young. Lund put them right together and nowhere to go that time, and down he goes.
That's big for the Titans. Third and 11 situation now for the Spartans. You have to hope your coverage holds up here, but the big question is who on this line and who in the linebacker position is going to stop the run? Moore's back there to the right. High snap, they give it to Moore, up the gut. It gets filled by Razo and he stops him. Big stop by Razo to fill the gap. He read it.
Now it's decision time for Hempfield. Take a look at that clock. 9 minutes and running.
Still only a 1-score game.
Looks like they're going to go for it.
9 minutes remaining on a 4th and 7. 2 timeouts left for the Spartans. 3 for the Titans. Hard count. No one jumps. Battaglia got close but didn't cross the line.
Just got to stay disciplined here if you're Shaler.
It's a 5-man set, 5 men in coverage. Littman takes the snap, looking left. Heaves it deep, wide open for Moore and over his head. I am speechless. It'll be a turnover on downs for what should have been a game-changing touchdown to Moore. Busted coverage, and Littman just over the head by about 3 feet.
Looked like he had all the time in the world, and when you take a look at that, he just maybe felt like, oh, he's wide open. That's rarely happened where receivers are wide open. He throws it, and just absolutely a huge missed throw there from the quarterback.
Now the Titans get another break, 8:32 remaining. They go down and score. It's a two-score game. They'll probably take around 3 minutes to get down there, obviously barring a big play. Now Schmatenka looking deep, wide open for Joey DiSabato, and big play, here he is. The 30, 20, won't get caught, and Cinderella will continue to dance into the end zone, Joey DiSabato. What a play.
What a throw from Keegan Smetanka. A couple of throws earlier in the game, not quite on point. That time right in the money, and wow.
How does he do it?
14-point swing in those last two plays. Those are the plays that win you games right there on defense and now on offense.
That's impossible to happen twice in a game, no? Two instant turnover on downs immediately on first possession touchdowns for the Titans. I mean, how many times could you have said that was going to happen, Matt? So now Povich puts that one through. He is perfect on the night and puts the Titans up 30-17 over the Spartans with 18 seconds remaining.
Yeah, line drive kick there from Povich. It's up and good, but
hey, soccer players like to hit that thing hard, and he gets it through. Doesn't matter for the Shale Area Titans as they take the lead again.
Yeah, 80-yard touchdown for DiSabato, and that just
unreal.
Broke it wide open. Yeah, just
like, I don't like to say I'm a big predictor guy. I know you necessarily not the greatest thing in the world to try and predict plays, but man, that felt good saying barring a big play, and Joey DiSabato takes it 80 yards to the house.
Yeah, and I just saw on that near sideline, Brennan Knight slam his helmet in the ground in frustration. The captain of the defense was incredibly frustrated by that sequence of events.
I would be too. He's had such a good game, and it's so unfortunate. He's gotten through that offensive line. He's made this Titans offensive line struggle a lot tonight. You know, everyone else on the line has too, but man, he's had a monster game so far, and it's going to hurt a little bit when you give up a touchdown like that.
And then you just miss a touchdown the preceding play as well.
Yep, and Douglas now gives a boot, and it'll roll in between Moore and catcher. It'll be a touchback. So now with 8 minutes remaining and 18 seconds, the Spartans now have to get two more scores again, down 13.
And that's got to be pretty deflating if you're Hemphill. You look just a couple of feet away on the missed throw from a touchdown, and then you're running back chasing DiSabato and having no chance of getting them. But at the same time, give credit to Shaler. They held through, just gave enough pressure on the quarterback to force that missed throw, and then immediately go down and put six on the board.
And if you're the Titans, you gotta feel good. You gotta feel confident right now. And now we have a quarterback switch, but a run up the middle. It was catcher on the take. And Dominic DeTruff is now in at quarterback.
I think it's interesting. The Titans are running a lot of three down linemen right now, especially when they're trying to run. You'd think they'd bring a fourth in there.
They're going to go back to catcher. He's going to get stopped and get pinned down in the backfield. Big tackle there. Dale Hayden in on that tackle. The 6'1", 235 senior drags him down.
Operating that nose tackle right now. You bring Battaglia back in.
Third and five. The truth. Now trying to lead this offense into something special. Fakes the handoff. Has to scramble. Gets the pitch. Has to get yards, but he'll be stopped, I believe, maybe a half yard or a yard for a fourth and four situation.
Yeah, that wasn't executed too well on the fake. The running back was way too far ahead. Everyone knew it was going to be a fake with play action there.
And the truth, not a bad way to get it out there, but again, when you're throwing it directly laterally across, you're not throwing it any further upfield, so you've got to still make that yardage, and he didn't get there. So now Josh Riley has to get a good boot here. Orga's around the 45 of Shaler. It'll be a fake. And he didn't get there at all. What a call by the Spartans to go for it, but the Titans just get the ball back. They stopped them.
I don't know about the fake punt in that situation.
You still have 6 minutes, 53 seconds remaining.
Yeah, and that too. And the Titans got to be prepared for that because they only have so much time left on the board. You think it would be better just to put their offense out there. You got to try a comeback. And
now they're pinned at their 27-yard line.
Maybe not the best idea to put up to your special teams there. But
if the Titans go and put this score on the board, whether it be a field goal or a touchdown, you could say that might be the nail in the coffin. They give it to Razo up the middle. And for Razo right now, it's just clockwork for him, right? Get my 5 or 6 yards, keep this clock rolling, let's go.
Now, to be fair, if that fake punk did work, we'd be calling Coach Kiefer a genius.
Oh, Coach Kiefer.
For sure, but.
Oh, absolutely. It's a gutsy call. It's just questionable when you're only down 2 scores with so much time remaining. It almost shows a little bit of a distrust in your defense.
Well, but now Shaler's going to try to bleed the clock out the best they can and try to get out of here for the win.
Yep, if Shaler can go and maybe take about a minute more off of this clock and put up another score on the board, you could say this thing could be over. They give it to Razo. Gets the first down on the stretch. Moves the chains. Keeps the clock rolling. And again, Razo. He's having himself a game.
Yeah, Razo, one of the great things, he fights for every yard. You see, when we try to get there, like, can I get this first down? Definitely. Reach the ball across the plane. That's one of the great things you've seen from him all year long to start, just that willingness to fight for each and every yard.
He has such a good eye to say, all right, I see the yardage in front of me. I'm going to take this hit, but I'm going to try and get 2 more yards. So now first and 10, 5:30 remaining in this game. Titans looking to go 4-0. Spartans show blitz. They give it to Razo. He gets a couple of yards, I'd say 3. Clock keeps rolling. And what a game. Matt, we went from pregame thinking and talking to everybody saying, all right, this is the Shaler team that's on top right now. They've been rolling. Their defense has been lights out. Their offense has been a top-tier offense in the Whipple. We thought, all right, they should come in and do business, but the Spartans caused havoc for the last 3 quarters, and now in the last 7 minutes in this fourth quarter, the Titans have blown things out of the water.
They've definitely made them work for it, and if this result holds, this is a good showing by the Titans to come out strong here in the second half and that second quarter.
And they'll give it up. Back to Razo, who'll gain a couple more. Clock hits 4:35. And for the Titans, this was a very big wake-up call, I would say.
For sure. You can't underestimate any opponent. And for the rest of the year, they definitely shouldn't be underestimating opponents, but they showed some resolve to not let anything faze them. That 80-yard run there in the third quarter that set up a touchdown, but they responded. Now let's see if they can respond more and add to their lead.
And for the Spartans, game's not necessarily over yet, but with this clock dwindling down, it's a tough ask to come back down 13. It's going to be a quick pitch out. Caden Orga cuts back inside, takes a shot, gets to the 10-yard line. It'll be a fourth down, just under 4 minutes now. And for the Spartans, I think, again, this is a plum situation where I really think that they would want this game back. If this is one that they could look on their schedule and say, if I could replay any game in the first half, it might be this one.
Now let's see, if Povich can knock this through, this game is all but over. It would make it a 3-score game.
Povich has been perfect on the night, made a 34-yarder earlier. This will be a 27-yarder. Kick is up, and it is through. Mark Povich, perfect on the night. Puts the Titans up 3 scores, 33 to, oh no, it is a 2-score game still, technically.
Apologies, I can't do math right now.
I cannot either. My brain hurts from this game. But a 2-score game with the Titans lead 33 to 17 over the Spartans.
Yeah, one too many yellow flags, I think.
I think the yellow flags are starting to hurt my eyes here, ladies and gentlemen. But luckily, we haven't had many in the last couple of minutes. But again, back to talking about the Spartans. I mean, their schedule only gets harder from here. You've got Penn Trafford, Gateway, Seneca, Franklin, Plum, and Norwin to close out the season. And right now, if they're riding this wave, they've got to hope it comes down a little bit calmer.
Yeah, for sure. And with the last field goal, although it doesn't make it a three-score game, it does make it so they have to go down the field twice and score two touchdowns. You can't lose off of two possessions now. That's very important if they were to somehow get a big couple of big plays here.
Now catcher takes it inside of zone two, cutting left, looking for a gap. Gets a gap, still on his feet, but brought down just shy of the 40-yard line. Great takes by the returners tonight. Catcher has been on fire tonight for the Hempfield Spartans.
Although their hope is dwindling, they can still find some there. Great return now with 3:04 left.
Alex Weber was in on that tackle, stopping him from getting any more yardage.
Just got to see. You got to go quick. You have two timeouts. You used one earlier. But now you've got to hope you get some big plays here. You can still run the ball. That's been your strength, but you've got to rely on your passing game a little bit just from the time remaining, only 3:04 left. It's got to be quick for them.
So now DeTruth, standing in the back, five-man set, shotgun set. Takes the snap, looking left. Getting chased down by Battaglia. It's caught and thrown back after a gain of about four. It was a great look by DeTruth, found his man Maxwell short.
Yeah, and Raza got stepped on there, and that's not a good sign you want to see.
Absolutely.
Two injured Titans.
The 2023 Softball Slow Pitch League, and you're watching SATV!
And welcome back. After that injury timeout, Ewing was able to walk off on his own power. Good to see we haven't had any major injuries on the field other than, well, not seeing Joe DeRuspoli for the second half. We have yet to be told what happened to him. We haven't even really seen him at all involved. Now DeTruth looking right. High pass, floated out of bounds. It was incomplete. It'll be a fourth down and five.
Incomplete.
So Matt, what have you seen, or excuse me, what did you just see from the Titans in this fourth quarter that really just helped them propel themselves into a win here tonight?
I think it's just the defense. They locked up finally. The worst thing they did in that second half was that 80-yard run, but they really didn't get anything else, and now with the turnover on downs they just forced, that tough pass high, then good job just knocking them out of bounds, not committing a late hit flag. And now with mid 54, let's just run the clock out and get out of here with a win.
And for Shaler, you got to be happy with what is going on with your team right now, right? You struggled in that last 10 minutes of the first quarter, that huge second quarter, struggled in the third, and then the fourth quarter, just a big boom of points to put yourselves up and, you know, back into the win column again for another week. So now a quick pitch out. Tretanka finds Di Sabato. Surprised a couple of these guys are still on the field, especially with the names we said that have been coming up with some injuries. Again, Carson Pierce did get injured against Hampton in week two, last play of the game. He's out until North Hills, presumably, with a broken thumb. And you just got to wonder, you know, you kind of want to sub maybe a couple of these guys out. You don't want an injury here.
Yeah, especially with Razo cramping up at the last play. But regardless, minute 19 left. Spartans are not going to use their timeouts in all likelihood. So,
and the Titans will head into a victory formation, and a couple of scores coming in here. North Hills right now against Woodland Hills trails 21-14 with 7 minutes remaining. Pine Richland leads in the fourth quarter, 35-7 over the Seneca Valley Raiders. Franklin Regional, I believe, Gateway has the lead over Franklin Regional, 24-17, as these fourth quarter scores are starting to roll in. End of the third, actually, for Franklin Regional. Gateway, 24-17. So Gateway, the Gators, looking to make a big statement, starting the season 0-3, trying to upset the 3-0 Franklin Regional Panthers.
Yeah, that's an important matchup to look at as Shaler goes to play off at Franklin Regional next week. Gateway start off 0-3. Uncharacteristic for that team, has been one of the better teams in the Whippoorwill League for the past half decade plus.
Yeah, it's been a weird start, but again, you can't count them out. But for the Shaler Area Titans, we hit under 15 seconds. They go 4-0. Into week 5 they go. The Hempfield Spartans will go 1-3 on the season as the clock hits zero, as the Shaler Titans defeat the Hempfield Spartans 33-17 in Greensburg at Spartan Stadium. Join us down on the field for post-game coverage of tonight's game.
This is the 2023 Shaler Area football team, and you're watching SATV.
And welcome down on the field for post-game coverage of tonight's game. John Irwin alongside Matt Perucca for coverage of what we just saw, where the Titans just beat the Spartans 33-17. And what a game we just saw unfold here at Spartan Stadium.
Absolutely, and it's not the game that you'd expect from a Shaler team, especially this year. A lot of penalties, a lot of unforced mistakes. Officially, we've got 10 penalties for 90 yards, and it's just something that continuing into conference play, and now with Franklin Regional next week, it's just something they've got to cut down on. Hopefully, this game is just the one anomaly, but from a penalty perspective, they're just shooting themselves in the foot, and that's really something you don't want to see going up against a team like Hempfield, which you would think would have been a little bit better if you could have just controlled that game. But they didn't really control that game. That sequence there at the end, that missed pass into the end zone, and then DeSabato's 80-yard touchdown scamper. That's the play. That's the turning point of the game. That secured the Titan victory. And, John, what do you got to say about some of the scores coming around with the Whippoorwill?
Yeah, the Whippoorwill has been, I believe, just turned upside down right now. We just had word that number one in 5A, Penn Hills, has just lost to 0-3 Moon at Moon 14-13 after a fumbled snap late in the fourth quarter. If that doesn't help the Titans out, I don't know what else will for confidence, because right now you just saw the number one team in your section and the number one team in the Whippoorwill lose. Woodland Hills has also just beat North Hills 21-20 now, so in section, that now has just played a factor into it. So if you're the Titans, you got to say to yourself, all right, now we're going into Franklin next week, who are currently down to 0-3 Gateway 24-17 as they are into the fourth quarter. So if you're a Titan right now, you're saying, all right, we just played what I would say is one of our most undisciplined, maybe I'd say mistake, you know, like you said, can't have 10 penalties. You can't, right? But if this is your worst game and your most undisciplined game of the season and you still win 33-17, I wouldn't say you're happy with it, but it's a little bit of a, we're not in the worst place right now. Because if that's your best game, that's a sign of trouble.
Yeah, that's a great thing. We come talk about just the expectations. 2 years ago, we would not be saying this. We'd be absolutely ecstatic that they won this game.
Absolutely.
But now they just got to get healthy, and they've got to go take a look at the film room, learn some things, made some adjustments there in that second quarter. You can win the game at any point. They really helped themselves in that second quarter with that 17-point unanswered run that they made. But now they just got to get healthy, too.
And you speak about healthy, right?
Yeah.
JoJo Rispoli.
Yeah, that is a huge piece, especially with Carson Pierce already out. That middle linebacker room is looking pretty thin right now.
Yeah, Sammy Tapu had a really good game, I thought, in my opinion. I believe a sack and a lot of tackles in his name tonight, around 3 tackles, 5 tackles, somewhere in that range. But it's just a tough loss when you lose your senior starting linebacker and then another rising junior in JoJo Rispoli. I mean, that's just a tough loss to have, especially in a non-section game. And then, like you said, you only get Pierce back probably around North Hills late into conference play. And if Rispoli's injury is anything significant, you may not get him back for the rest of the season.
And yeah, that's a good thing, too, about Shaler's schedule. I know you play all those teams back to back to back, those four great teams in Fox Chapel. And you just have to think, okay, at least the schedule's set up to where your most important games, you guys are hopefully going to be healthy. I mean, section play is starting for a lot of conference play, starting for a lot of these teams already. Shaler plays those last 5 games are all conference games. And they've got to look to take this game into perspective, take all these games into perspective. And you're really in a good spot right now. 4-0.
You got to be pumped.
We do not know the last time these guys were 4-0. This is awesome. This is a great time to be around Shaler football. And they just got to keep rolling, finding ways to win. It wasn't pretty, but they still won. Imagine if we lost this game.
Yes.
So that's a positive. You still won the game. And now you get to go in for what's going to be a big matchup against Franklin Regional, a primer for that Woodland Hills game on homecoming, which is going to be a real big one. Not only is it on homecoming, it's the first game of conference play.
Yeah, absolutely. That's going to be a big one for sure at Woodland Hills on homecoming. But obviously next week, the Shaler Titans head into Franklin Regional to play the Panthers in Franklin Regional. So join us for that. For us down here on the field, John Owen and Matt Brucker, thanks for tuning in, Shaler area, and have a good night.